Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the solution and discussion on gate question paper in mechanical engineering subjects. And this is lecture number 24. We are going to solve few problems on the Rankine cycle. And before we take up the discussion, these are all the books I published: Design of Transmission System, Turbo Machines, Heat and Mass Transfer, Operations Research, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion, Thermal Engineering, Fluid Mechanics and Machinery. And I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures of all the subjects and the solution to the gate question paper for the benefit of mechanical engineering students. I request the students to subscribe the channel and use the videos for your better learning and to pass in the gate examination. So this is absolutely free for the mechanical engineering students. And the first question from 2010 question paper: in a steam power plant operating on Rankine cycle, the steam enters the turbine at 4 megapascal 350 degree Celsius and exits at 15 kilopascal. Then it enters a condenser and exits as saturated water. Next a pump feeds back the water to the boiler. Adiabatic efficiency of the turbine is 90%. The thermodynamic states of water and the steam are given in the table. H is the specific enthalpy, S is the specific entropy, and V is the specific volume. Subscript F and G denotes the saturated liquid and saturated vapor. So the properties are given. Steam at 4 megapascal 350 degree Celsius, it is superheated steam. The enthalpy of superheated steam 3092.5 and the specific entropy of superheated steam 6.5821 and the specific volume of the superheated steam 0.06645. At 15 kilopascal, it is the properties are given. So the HF equal to 225.94, HG equal to 25.99.1, SF equal to 0.7549, SG equal to 8.0085 and VF equal to 0.001014 and VG equal to 10.02. So this is a simple Rankine cycle. And the data given, so the we take the diagram. So the data given, H1 equal to 3092 superheated steam enthalpy, superheated steam, and HF equal to HF3 equal to 225.94. So this value is saturated liquid HF3. And this is the temperature entropy diagram for the simple Rankine cycle. Now we have to calculate the other enthalpy, H2 and H4. To calculate H2, we take the expansion, the isentropy expansion between 1 and 2. For isentropy expansion, S1 equal to S2. So S1 is the entropy of the superheated steam and S2 is the entropy of the wet steam. So calculating S1 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. So substituting the values, 6.5821 equal to 0.7549 plus SFG2 equal to SG2 minus SF2. So 8.0085 minus 0.7549. So calculating X2 equal to 0.803. Now we calculate the enthalpy here at the point 2. So H2 equal to HF2 plus HFG2, which is 225.94 plus 0.803. And HFG2 equal to HG2 minus HF2, which is 2599.1 minus 225.94, which is 2131.59 kilojoules per kilogram. Then we calculate the H4. H4 equal to H3 plus VF3 into P4 minus P3. Actually, VF3 minus P4 minus P3 is the pump work. So the H4 equal to H3 plus the pump work. So 225.94 plus 0.001014 into 4000 minus 15 equal to 230 kilojoules per kilogram. And the net work output, so we calculate the net work output, W equal to, so we have the turbine efficiency 90%, so 0.9 into turbine efficiency, turbine work output minus pump work input. So 0.9 into H1 minus H2 minus H4 minus H3. So substituting all the numerical values, 0.9 into 3092.5 minus 2131.59 minus H4 equal to 230 minus H3 equal to 225.94, so which is 860.76 kilojoules per kilogram. Then the heat supplied equal to QS equal to H1 minus H4, which is 3092.5 minus 230 equal to 2865.5 kilojoules per kilogram. So these are all the calculations. Now we take up the question. So this is there are two questions from the problem statement. So we have the first question, common data question, the net work output in kilojoules per kilogram of the cycle. So we calculated net work output as 860.76 kilojoules per kilogram. So among the four answers given here, the correct answer is 860 kilojoules per kilogram. The second question is heat supplied in kilojoules per kg of the cycle. So we calculated 2862.5. So the correct answer here, it is 2863 kilojoules per kilogram. So we calculate for the Rankine cycle all the parameters, and there are two questions, and the two questions were answered. The next question is from 2011 question paper. The value of enthalpy of steam at inlet and the outlet of a steam turbine in a Rankine cycle are 2800 kilojoules per kilogram and 1800 kilojoules per kilogram respectively. Neglecting the pump work, the specific steam consumption in kilogram per kilowatt hour is, four options are given, 3.6, 0.36, 0.06, 0.01. So we calculate. First we calculate the turbine work output. So enthalpy at the entry of the turbine 2800, enthalpy at the outlet of the turbine 1800. So turbine work is 2800 minus 1800 equal to 1000 kilojoules per kilogram. So pump work is neglected. So the specific steam consumption kilogram per kilowatt hour. So the formula is steam rate or specific steam consumption 3600 divided by net work output. So 3600 divided by WT minus WP. So, substituting all the numerical values, 3600 divided by 1000, WT equal to 1000 minus pump work equal to 0. So, calculating it is 3.6 kilogram per kilowatt hour. So, the answer is 3.6, option A, 3.6 kilogram per kilowatt hour. We take the next question from 2014 question paper. An ideal reheat Rankine cycle operates between the pressure limits of 10 kilopascal and 8 megapascal, with the reheat being done at 4 megapascal, and the enthalpy of the steam is 31, the temperature of the steam at inlet of the both the turbine is 500 degrees Celsius, and the enthalpy of the steam is 3185 kilojoules per kilogram at the exit of the high pressure turbine, and 2247 kilojoules per kilogram at the exit of the low pressure turbine. The enthalpy of water at the exit of the pump is 191 kilojoules per kilogram. Use the following table for relevant data. So the enthalpy entropy of the superheated steam. So superheated steam temperature 500 degrees Celsius, pressure in megapascal 4 and 8, and the data are given. Specific volume, enthalpy and the entropy are given. Now disregarding the pump work, the cycle efficiency is. So we have to calculate for a simple reheating Rankine cycle. So the answer is 40.73%. So efficiency of the reheat cycle is 40.73%. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, this is the simple reheat cycle, and these are all the enthalpies given. H1 equal to 3399 kilojoules per kilogram, entry inlet enthalpy of the HP turbine. H2 equal to 3185 kilojoules per kilogram, exit of the high pressure turbine. H3 inlet of the low pressure turbine, 3446 kilojoules per kilogram, and H4 exit of the low pressure turbine, 2247 kilojoules per kilogram. H6 outlet of the pump 191 kilojoules per kilogram, and we have to calculate the efficiency. First we calculate the turbine work. So turbine work, there are two levels of turbine, HP turbine and low pressure turbine. For HP turbine, H1 minus H2. For low pressure turbine, H3 minus H4. So substituting all the numerical values, 3399 minus 3185 plus 3446 minus 2247 equal to 1413 kilojoules per kilogram. And we calculate the heat supplied. So heat supplied equal to H1 minus H6. So for the boiler, H1 minus H6 plus for reheating, H3 minus H2. So substituting numerical values, 3399 minus 191 plus 3446 minus 3185 equal to 3469 kilojoules per kilogram. Then the efficiency equal to eta equal to WT, because we neglect the pump work. So, WT by QS, heat supplied equal to 1413 divided by 3469 equal to 0.4073, which is 14.73%. So that is what the efficiency of the reheat cycle we filled in the previous slide. The next question from 2014 question paper, steam with a specific enthalpy of 3214 kilojoules per kilogram enters adiabatic turbine operating at a steady state with a flow rate of 100 kilograms per second. As it expands at a point where the enthalpy is 2920 kilojoules per kilogram, 1.5 kilograms is extracted for heating purpose. The remaining 8.5 kilograms per second further expands in the turbine exit where the enthalpy is 2374 kilojoules per kilogram. Neglecting the changes in the kinetic energy and the potential energy, the net power output of the turbine is in kilowatt, dash kilowatt. The answer is 7581 kilowatts. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, this is the simple reheat cycle, regenerative cycle. So, there is a boiler, the steam enters the turbine with the amount of steam entry is 10 kilograms per second. 1.5 kg per second of steam is taken with the enthalpy 2920 kilojoules per kilogram, and the enthalpy at the one entry of the turbine is 3214 kilojoules per kilogram, and 8.5 kilograms per second of the steam is flowing further in the stages and leaving at state 3 where the enthalpy is 2374 kilojoules per kilogram and the mass flow rate is 8.5 kilograms per second is flowing through the condenser pump and coming into the open feed water heater and leaving the open feed water heater, then the same quantity is flowing back to the boiler. Now, the power output of the turbine, that is the question, power output of the turbine equal to 10 kilogram per second is entering here, it is flowing between 1 and 2. So, 10 into H1 minus H2 plus remaining 8.5 is flowing through the rest of the stages. So, 8.5 into H2 minus H3. So, substituting numerical values, 10 into 3214 minus 2920 plus 8.5 into 2920 minus 2374. So, calculating the power output of the turbine equal to 7581 kilowatts. So, this is the answer. We filled the previous slide with the 7581 kilowatts. The next question is from 2015 question paper. Steam enters a well-insulated turbine and expands isentropically throughout. At an intermediate pressure of at an intermediate pressure, 20% of the mass is extracted for the process of heating and the remaining steam expands isentropically to 9 kilopascal. So, inlet to the turbine, pressure equal to 14 megapascal, temperature equal to 560 degrees Celsius, enthalpy equal to 3486 kilojoules per kilogram and entropy equal to 6.6 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. At intermediate stage, HE equal to 2776 kilojoules per kilogram. At the exit of the turbine, pressure equal to 9 kilopascal, HF equal to 174 kilojoules per kilogram, HG equal to 2574 kilojoules per kilogram, SF equal to 0.6 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and SG equal to 8.1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. If the flow rate of the steam entering the turbine is 100 kilograms per second, then the work output is dash megawatt. So, it is a simple regenerative Rankine cycle. So, the answer is 125.56 megawatts. So, the power output, then the work output of the turbine is 125.56 megawatts. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, this is the simple regenerative cycle. 100 kg of steam is entering here, 20 kg of steam is taken for heating purpose and remaining 80 kg is flowing through the rest of the turbine. So, it is entering the condenser, the steam leaving the turbine enters the condenser and circulated back to the open feed water heater. Then again the 100 kilograms per second of water is flowing to the boiler. Now the data given here, inlet to the turbine P1 equal to, here P1 equal to 14 megapascal, T1 equal to 560 degrees Celsius and the enthalpy is 3486 kilojoules per kilogram, entropy S1 equal to 6.6 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. At the intermediate stage, so at the point 2, H2 equal to 2776 kilojoules per kilogram and the exit of the turbine H3 equal to, HF3 equal to 174 kilojoules per kilogram, HG3 equal to 2574 kilojoules per kilogram and SF3 equal to 0.6 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and SG3 equal to 8.1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now, we have to calculate for isentropic flow. between the turbine S1 equal to S3. So S3 equal to SF3 plus X3 into SG3 minus SF3. So substituting all the numerical values, S1 equal to 6.6, SF3 equal to 0.6 plus X3 into 8.1 minus 0.6 equal to, so calculating X3 equal to 0.8. Then we calculate the H3 enthalpy here. So H3 equal to HF3 plus X3 into HG minus HF3 equal to 174 plus 0.8 into 2574 minus 174 equal to 2094 kilojoules per kilogram. Now we have to calculate the work output of the turbine. So W equal to, so 100 kilograms per second is entering, it is flowing between 1 and 2. So 100 into 1 H1 minus H2 plus remaining 80 kilograms flowing rest of the stage. So 80 into H2 minus H3. So substituting numerical values, 100 into 3486 minus 2776 plus 80 into 2776 minus 2094. So calculating 125,560 kilowatts, which is 125.56 megawatts. So the answer to the problem is 125.56 megawatt. So it is a simple regenerative cycle. So what is expected? You have to draw the circuit and you should know the equations to calculate the work output, efficiency, heat supply, everything. And next question, in a Rankine cycle, enthalpies at the turbine entry and the outlet are 3159 kilojoules per kilogram and 2187 kilojoules per kilogram respectively. If the specific pump work is 2 kilojoules per kilogram, the specific steam consumption kilogram per kilowatt hour of the cycle on net output is dash. So we calculate turbine work output WT equal to inlet enthalpy minus exit enthalpy, 3157 minus 2187 equal to 970 kilojoules per kilogram. And the pump work input is given as 2 kilojoules per kilogram. So the specific steam consumption or the steam rate equal to 3600 divided by WT minus WP. So 3600 divided by 970 minus 2 equal to 3.72 kilogram per kilowatt hour. So the answer to the problem is 3.72 kilogram per kilowatt hour. And the next question from 2016 question paper. In a steam power plant operating on ideal Rankine cycle, superheated steam enters the turbine at 3 MPa and 350 degree Celsius. The condenser pressure is 75 kPa. The thermal efficiency of the cycle is dash percentage. So the given data at 75 kPa, HF equal to 384.39 kJ per kilogram, HFG equal to 2278.6 kJ per kilogram, VF equal to 0.001037 meter cube per kilogram, SF equal to 1.213 kJ per kilogram Kelvin and SFG equal to 6.2434 kJ per kilogram Kelvin. At the inlet condition, 3 MPa, temperature equal to 350 degrees Celsius, enthalpy equal to 3115.3 kJ per kilogram and entropy equal to 6.7428 kJ per kilogram. Now, this is the simple Rankine cycle. So, the temperature entropy diagram of a simple Rankine cycle. 1 to 2 isentropic expansion, 2 to 3 condenser, 3 to 4 the pump and 4 to 1 the heating in the boiler. And the specific enthalpy what is given, H1 equal to 3115.6 kJ per kilogram and H3 equal to HF3 equal to 384.39 kJ per kilogram. So, from the H3 is HF3. And the pump work we calculate, pump work equal to VF3 into P4 minus P3. So, which is H4 minus H3. So, the calculating the pump work 0.001037 P4 equal to 3 MPa is given 3000 kPa minus 75 equal to 3.03 kJ per kilogram and H4 equal to H3 plus 3.03 which is 384.39 plus 3.03 equal to 387.42 kJ per kilogram. For isentropy expansion between 1 and 2, so we have S1 equal to S2 which is SF2 plus X2 into SFG2 and calculating, substituting all the values. So, S1 equal to 6.7428 equal to SF2 equal to 1.213 plus X2 into SFG2 equal to 6.2434. So, calculating X2 equal to 0.88. Then we calculate the enthalpy at the outlet of the turbine H2 equal to h of 2 plus x3 into h of g3, which is 384.39 plus 0.88 into 2278.6 equal to 2389.56 kilojoules per kilogram. Now, we have all the enthalpies. Now, we calculate the turbine work output. So, WT equal to h1 minus h3, which is 3115.6 minus 2389.56 equal to 726.04 kilojoules per kilogram. And heat supplied equal to h1 minus h4, which is 3115.6 minus 384.39 equal to 2731.21 kilojoules per kilogram. Then the cycle efficiency, eta equal to net work output divided by the heat supplied, which is turbine work minus the pump work divided by the heat supplied. So, substituting all the numerical values, 726.04 minus 3.03 divided by 2731.21 into 100 equal to 26.47%. So, the efficiency of the simple Rankine cycle is 26.47%. The next question from 2017 question paper, in a Rankine cycle for steam power plant, the turbine entry and the exit enthalpies are 2803 kilojoules per kilogram and 1800 kilojoules per kilogram respectively. The enthalpy of water at the pump entry and the exit are 121 kilojoules per kilogram and 124 kilojoules per kilogram respectively. The specific steam consumption of the cycle is dash kilogram per kilowatt hour. So, first we calculate the turbine work. So, turbine work equal to entry enthalpy 2803 minus exit enthalpy 1800, which is 1003 kilojoules per kilogram. And the pump work input equal to exit enthalpy 124 minus inlet enthalpy 121, which is 3 kilojoules per kilogram. Then we calculate the specific steam consumption. The formula is steam rate equal to 3600 divided by WT minus WP equal to 3600 divided by 1000 minus 3 equal to 3.6 kilogram per kilowatt hour. So, the answer is 3.6 kilogram per kilowatt hour. The next problem from 1990 question paper, a power station produces 500 megawatt of power. Assuming a plant thermal efficiency of 33%, calculate the rate of cooling water flow required in tons per hour. If the rise in the cooling water temperature to be restricted to 5 degrees Celsius and the specific heat of water used is 4.2 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Heat supplied, we calculate the heat supplied from the given data, power divided by the efficiency. So, 500 divided by 0.333 equal to 1501.5 megajoules per second. Next, we calculate the heat rejected. So, heat rejected equal to heat supplied minus the power. So, 1501.5 minus 500 equal to 1001.5 megajoules per second. So, the rate of cooling water required. So, from the in the condenser, so M equal to heat rejected by Cp into delta T. So, substituting 1001.5 into 1000. So, it is given in megajoules per second into 1000. So, divided by 4.2 into 5, that is 47,690.48 kilograms per second. So, we have to convert into tons per hour. So, multiplying by 3600 and dividing by 1000. So, dividing by 1000 to convert kilogram into tons, multiplying by 3600 to convert seconds into hour. So, the answer is 1.72 in 10 power 5 tons per hour. So, tons per hour of cooling water is required in the condenser for the steam power station of 500 megawatt of power. So, we stop here. So, thank you for watching. So, you please post your comments in the YouTube video comments box. You subscribe the channel for updated video in the channel. And you can write to me to my mail ID for any clarification. And we will meet again in the next video with additional problems in the Rankine cycle from various gate question papers.